Hi, I'm Rick with TGW.com. I'm inside the Devlin Lodge, just off of hole number 18 here at Flint Hills National Golf Club. And we had a lot of fun testing the new F9 Speedback irons from Cobra. And I'm going to talk to you about my first impressions when seeing and hitting the clubs for the first time, the results and the data that we got from testing the clubs, and then the technology that goes into the clubs that gave us the results that we saw. So first impressions, first of all, pulling the clubs out of the box in the bag estate, the clubs look very modern. They're definitely game improvement clubs. These clubs are designed for distance and forgiveness. So there's no doubt about it, and you can recognize that just at a glance from a distance away. Putting the club into the playing position, these clubs are called Speedback irons, and when you put the club down at address, contrary to the F8 of last year, you definitely can see the mass sticking out behind the blade. So I know that's something that look really kind of distracts a lot of players, but positioning the weight low and back, like we'll talk about, is really a lot of the technology that goes into this iron. And if you can get away from seeing that, I think you're really going to like the results. So like I said, it definitely is a game improvement club. It's designed for forgiveness and for distance, and both in the bag and at address behind the ball, you see that. So just be forewarned. But now to the results. I'm really driven personally on performance of a golf club. I know I can only do so much with my swing, and if I can make the ball do something more, then that excites me. And the F8 irons of last year, I never came right out and said this, but I would have put those up against just about anybody, and I guarantee you they would have stood their ground. So I was very anxious to test the new F9s, and the performance is definitely there. Again, I saw an increase in ball speed. The trajectory, the launch angle, the spin rate were very appropriate, but with the faster ball speed, I was hitting the clubs 8 to 10 yards further than some of the current irons that I've tested this year. So if you are looking for a distance iron, the F9 Speedback from Cobra is definitely that. Yet, like I said though, launch angles and spin rates were appropriate to where you don't have to worry about the ball coming down and not holding the green. I was getting 75 to 90 feet elevation, and the shots were landing on about a 40 degree angle. So with about 6,000 RPMs in my 7-iron, that's plenty to hold the green. I was swinging these clubs at about 83 with the 5-iron down to about 80 with the 7-iron, and I was getting carry distances of 190 to 200 plus with that low of club head speed out of the 5-iron, and I was getting carry distance out of the 7-iron up to 170 to 172. So again, the distance is definitely there. So great products. The clubs felt solid. I can't really describe the pitch. It was just a nice solid, maybe more on the thud side versus the ting, if that makes any sense. Kind of a deeper, more penetrating sound versus a high pitched. But again, sounded great. The ball flew great. The technology that goes into the F9 Speedback, probably a combination of things. Number one, it is a CNC milled face, so they're able to make the face incredibly thin, and they're able to control the tolerances. It's a perfectly flat face, and the grooves are milled to perfection. They do use 3 different types of grooves, depending on what iron you hit, to give you the right spin rates for those shots. So milled face, they've got what they call the power shell, which is a very thin channel that's cut into the sole of the club, which again allows them to get a lot of spring into the face and then reposition weight where it's ideal. And then on top of that, it is the Speedback weight distribution. And this is, like I said, a much thicker club from front to back, and Cobra is taking the weight. And again, just like any golf club, they're trying to move it low and away from the face as far as possible, which is going to give you high launch and better ball flight parameters for more distance. So I think with a combination of the thin milled face, the power shell, thin channel that's in the sole of the club, and then just the weight distribution is all what contributed to the shots that I were hitting with excellent performance and very good distance without really changing my club head speed. So stock shaft in the standard F9s is the KBS 90, available in different flexes, and then they have an Atmos graphite available. Like the rest of the line, they've gone to the Lampkin 58 Plus grip. It's just slightly oversized, and all the clubs in the Cobra line have the Connect. It's a great new product, and again, it's definitely, I would not say this is a player's club. Someone looking for workability and the ability to flight different shots, this club is designed to go high and straight. So if this sounds like something for you, rest assured that with TGW's Mulligan buyback policy, you can try the F9 Speedbacks, and if for some reason you don't love them, you just don't have to keep them.